9:54 start time. Second to play, Karl, Vilips, Melbourne, Australia.
Karl's absolutely bombed his drive off the tee. First hole's a par 5, and it looks like he's going to be able to use as little as either a 5-wood or a hybrid to get to the green here. He's got water all the way down the right. He cannot miss right. He knows that if he goes for an into, and that if he gets in the bunker, that he can still, with his bunker play, he can still get within six feet of the hole and walk off with his birdie. Karl's got 4 hybrid in hand. He likes it. Let's see what the result is. Oh, right next to the pin. And over the back of the green. So she went over the back of the green there. Yeah, good chip. Got the birdie on the opening hole. Birdie for Karl on the opening hole. Good start. Good drive. Karl's only used 3-wood off the tee so that he could come in with about a 3/4 sand wedge here. Spin. Oh, it didn't stop. Didn't check at all. A little bit out there. It's probably a good 20 feet. Karl's got about 16, 17 feet. Birdie. Got it. It's 2 under after 2. Okay, I'm on the third hole. Karl's going to be going straight over this bunker you can see in front to the right. That's his line. If he goes straight over that, he's going to get himself about 50 yards less into the green than if he was down the left side. Second shot into the third hole. It's just sitting down a bit in the rough. That's an excellent shot. That's only a few feet from the flag. Alright, Karl putting for his third birdie in the first 3 holes. This would be a good start. missing an absolute sitter for his third consecutive birdie. Karl's now on the fourth tee. He's going to be hitting this over the left-hand corner. Let's not overdo it though. Let's get that follow through. Should be okay. Just worried that he's overdone that a bit, which is a tendency that all golfers make at times. Karl's hit his drive 260 into the breeze on this par 5, which is only going to leave him with either a 5-wood or a hybrid into the green. Second shot has come up just on the edge of the green and fallen back onto the fringe. But we've got a few options here. He can use the putter or he could blade it with his wedge. Let's see. I'm guessing he's going to blade it with his wedge because... chip that, you should have just bladed it at the leading edge. Half a cut from his right to left, so he should be driving this inside his right hip, just in case it hasn't broken, hasn't given the hole away. This should look good about a nice firm face. Don't give the hole away. After missing two absolute sitters for birdies on the last two holes, Karl probably realises that he's going to be spending a bit of time down at the putting green after here, because you can't miss those sort of putts on a regular basis and expect to win tournaments. They've played four holes and he should be four under. I don't have to tell you where that's gone. Let's see how you go. Yeah, well out. I'm not happy about that. Hold on, good sound, sir. The riser, you can see it going past others, but not the birdie putts. So he's 200 after 5. There's water all the way down the left on this hole, so he's got to keep it out to the right. Like that. Yes, dead in the middle of the fairway. Umbrella with one of his playing partners, which is what I like to see. He understands the difference between competition and just being a good kid. Well, the boys have had a 1 hour weather delay, and what Karl's doing here is cleaning his ball. So he's lifting, parking his ball, lifting it, cleaning it, and you're allowed to place it back. So, obviously, during weather delay, there's no warming up allowed or practicing, so the players come out back onto the course completely cold. Not cold as in terms of temperature, but cold as in terms of not having hit a ball for over an hour. This is always a challenge, because Karl had putted for birdie on four of the five holes that he had played, and he's on the sixth hole here, in perfect position off the tee. It's 110 yards out. Right, after a 2 hour delay, a couple of false restarts, Karl's finally ready to play his second shot on the sixth hole. This is hard because he hasn't been allowed to go out and warm up or practice. Doesn't like it. Yeah, this is just so tough. He's hasn't hit a ball in 2 hours, and is expected to come back out and keep on hitting the way that he was. And he was in absolutely A1 position off the tee, in a spot that he would normally stick it to within 10 feet, and he's gone over the back of the green. He's just absolutely airmailed this green. Let's see what he can do here. Well, it's a pretty snazzy looking shot. There's not a whole lot more he could have done there. He's landed, that's about as good as he could possibly have done. Oh, I can't really call the par safe. So that's a bogey that really has just come out of nowhere. He'd done a great drive off the tee before the horn sounded to stop play. And after over 2 hours waiting around the clubhouse, not being able to warm out as the players were expected to come out and just recommence play, which is a lot easier than it sounds without having warmed up. Alright, on the 7th hole, par 3. Karl's just taken a bogey here on the par 4 from the middle of the fairway, 110 yards out. Right, we've got to regroup. It's the same for everybody. Yep, good shot. About 10-15 feet right of the flag. Should be able to see it just there. About 15 feet, maybe 20 feet. That was a good effort. Oh, just over the right lip. Good putt. That's a big draw. Get that ball further forward. He's just drawing him a bit since he got back from the suspension of play. Should break 2 to 3 cups left to right. It's all about four feet past. It was never high enough. Hold on. Good par. So hopefully the two pars after that unfortunate bogey on the 6th, Karl's now settled down, hopefully. Karl's drive was stuck in behind a clump of palms here, so he's had to come out sideways. He's cut his losses. I think he's realised he can't actually hit through a tree. So he's going to try and get this up and down from around 100 yards out. Yeah, good shot. He didn't fall for the sucker pin and go for the flag there. He's put it to the heart of the green and it's fed back towards the flag. He's probably got about 10 feet left for his part. Just had a good read off one of the other players. So he should have a good idea of what this part's going to do. That was a good part. Caught a big chunk of the net. It's a good part. They can't all drop in. Just take your bogey and make sure your next drive hits the fairway. Got a real good drive on the 10th here. Wedge in hand. Seems a bit skinny. We'll see how it goes. Oh, nothing wrong with that. A couple of feet for birdie. Let's hope he can get a short one day. I've seen one of the other boys' putts on the same line as him, so he should be aware that it's going to break two cuts right to left at holding speed. Just make sure you don't use low side. That's low side. Oh, we got it. Well done. Good birdie. Just checking for roots there. Oh no, he's found a ball there. I was wondering what he was doing. Gotta be careful, mate, you don't get pinged for testing the ground. Trees in his path between there and the green, so he can't take the aerial route. He's going to have to knock it down and run it up. Oh, it's a clever shot. Very clever shot. He's only got about 10 feet there for his birdie. Oh, forgot to hit it. Cardinal scent, right in the jaws. Right, Karl's gone on this par 5. Karl's gone driver and then 5 iron so that he's leaving himself 100 yards to the pins. And by doing that, he's taken out going into this big bunker on the right side of the fairway, and also taken out the water. It's a smart play. Oh, that's a club long. Now, this putt's going to break from his right to left by a good foot or two here. He's going to have to watch his speed. This putt's all about the speed. He won't be thinking about holding it, he's thinking about just lagging it to the hole. Hard for me to really see right here as to how close that is, but I think it's about 2 feet short. I must be closer than that. Yeah, it's about a foot short, so that was a good lag putt from Karl. Oh, that's a pretty handy shot. I'll give him a good look at birdie there. Karl's wedges are just a little bit off today. He'll walk off with par break. Karl's not as close as he'd like to be. He's probably about 15 feet. Pink spangle. Yeah, that's reasonable. Looks like a pink Donald Duck. Look at him. Spoonbill. That's just embarrassing. Alright, I worked out why Karl was playing hybrid there. He just wanted to lay up short of this lake in front of the green. So he's just leaving himself a simple 60 degree log wedge. So it was a smart play on Karl's part. He could have gone for the green. It was just such a low percentage with the way that the lake protects the green. Oh, that's pretty nifty. He's got that for a birdie. So he's really thought this hole out well. Well done, boss. So you've had a lot of these today and you haven't got many of them. In fact, I think you've only got one. Been a long day. They teed off at 9:54 and it's now 6 o'clock. So they've been out here for 8 hours. So a lot of weather delay, relatively slow round as well with pace of play. So it's been a long one. But last hole, what Karl's got to be thinking about right now is just hitting this drive straight down the middle and giving himself every opportunity of it being a good result. By doing all the things that are required in his pre-shot routine and his setup and with his follow through. Last drive of the day, let's keep the focus. This last chance of the day to get a birdie.
Good shot.
Oh, look at that rip back to the flag. Oh, he got it. So that's even round for Karl.